beats fast, colors and promises. How to be brave? How can I love when I'm afraid to fall? But watching you stand alone.
Together in the presence of God to witness the marriage of Monica and Ray David and to rejoice with them. Marriage is a gift of God, and it is a means of His grace in which man and woman become one flesh. It is God's purpose that as husband and wife give themselves to each other in love, they shall grow together and be united in that love, as Christ is united with His church. The union of man and woman in heart, body, and mind is intended for their mutual comfort and help, that they may know each other with delight and tenderness in acts of love, and when they are blessed with children, for the care and upbringing of these. In marriage, husband and wife give themselves to each other to care for each other in good times and bad. They are linked to each other's families, and they begin a new life together in that community. It is a way of life that all should reverence and none should lightly undertake. If anyone present here in this congregation knows a reason why Monica and Ray David may not lawfully marry, you must now declare it, speak now, or else forever hold your peace. It's a very good sign. Monica and Ray David, I look to you, and if either of you know a reason why you may not lawfully marry, you must now declare it. We're good to go, okay. So they've come together at this time to enter into this holy state. They've complied with the civil and canonical law, and they have been duly prepared to enter into this marriage. In the service today, they will give their consent to each other. They will exchange solemn vows, and in token of this, they will each give each other a ring. And to make the right start for this solemn and joyful occasion, we begin with prayer. Lord God, our Father, you have taught us through your Son that loving is fulfilling the law. Grant to these your servants that loving one another, they may continue in your love until their lives end. And we pray this through Jesus Christ, our Lord. All God's people said amen. 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 Now we enter after prayer. We enter in time of worship. You'll see words on the screen. So let's sing together.
Doubt, and to know you is to
So the songs that we just sang describe a relationship that we have with the living God, the living God of history. And the people that first ignited this wrote a book, several books, several letters in the New Testament. And we read them now because, we read a portion of one now simply because these are the eyewitnesses of what God had done for us and has done for us in Jesus Christ. So I'll invite you now to be seated, and we'll have our first reading from 1 John.
Our reading is from 1 John chapter 4, verses 7 through 21. Beloved, let us love one another, for love is from God, and whoever loves has been born of God and knows God. Anyone who does not love does not know God, because God is love. In this, the love of God was made manifest among us, that God sent his only Son into the world, so that we might live through him. In this is love, not that we have loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be the propitiation for our sins. Beloved, if God so loved us, we also ought to love one another. No one has ever seen God. If we love one another, God abides in us and his love is perfected in us. By this we know that we abide in him, and he in us, because he has given us his Spirit. And we have seen and testify that the Father has sent his Son to be the Savior of the world. Whoever confesses that Jesus is the Son of God, God abides in him, and he in God. So we have come to know and to believe the love that God has for us. God is love, and whoever abides in love abides in God, and God abides in him. By this is love perfected with us, so that we may have confidence for the day of judgment, because as he is, so also are we in this world. There is no fear in love, but perfect love casts out fear. For fear has to do with punishment, and whoever fears has not been perfected in love. We love because he first loved us. If anyone says, I love God, and hates his brother, he is a liar. For he who does not love his brother, whom he has seen, cannot love God, whom he has not seen. And this commandment we have from him: whoever loves God must also love his brother. This is our story, the word of the Lord.
Well, good afternoon. What a joy to be here. Let me remind you who I am. Not that I'm anybody at all special to you, but for whatever reason, God touched the heart of RD and my heart at the same time about 7 years ago when his story began, the tragic part of his story, and we have connected many times since. At that point, was a senior pastor, the rector of Christ Church in the North Dallas area. And RD and I, we spent hours on the phone. As I said to some people yesterday, that he's the only person, really the only person ever that I FaceTime with. And now that you see me, you're wondering why. What's the big deal? But I don't know, it was a sense of intimacy that we had, RD, over those course of the last 7 years. And I don't, I'm acquainted with his story. And I'm just so thankful that God has brought him to this place. Aren't you? And I don't know Monica as well. I don't know her story. But I know that as these two come together, a new story is going to be written, filled with redemption and restoration and hope and new life. What a great joy it is for me to share just a few moments of reflection with you about this. So when RD called, RD, pay attention. When RD called about 6 months ago, he asked if I would come and do the service and do the preaching. I was frankly overwhelmed. It was one of the great honors of my life. Will you stay for Sunday and preach as well? And I said, sure. But I know that RD, his commitment to the spoken word, to the preached word, is really significant. So I know that right now this is like an audition for tomorrow. So far I'm doing all right. So far I'm doing all right. He is aware that if I falter or fail at this, he'll step in for tomorrow. Monica, I'm sorry for that, but if this sermon doesn't get any better than it is now, we may have to shorten your honeymoon tomorrow. Let me just tell you what the sermon's all about, so you get it. All that the passage there from the first letter of John to the Christians was really summed up in those three words that I know you've heard before. They went so fast you may not have heard them in the passage. But it's a phrase, it's a meme. It's a nugget of knowledge that you probably have heard before that sums up everything that was read to you today. The writer says, God is love. You've heard that before, right? In fact, we probably have heard it too much. It becomes like a little Hallmark card greeting. And it ends up meaning nothing. God is love, well, that's a sentiment. That's an idea, that's a wish, it's a hope. But behind that is a reality that I want to describe to you, because either you're going to believe it or you're not. Either you're going to come to that understanding that there is a person behind this idea of God is love. Not just a person, but a personality. And not just a personality, but a character. And not just a character, but someone who can actually enter into your life and communicate a kind of love that will forever change your life. Or you'll say, no, it's just an antique religion. You see, there's an infection that's taken place in our Western culture today. And it's robbed it attempts to rob the joy and the wonder out of faith. It effectively says that all of us are accidental to the world, that there is no God, that God was just a metaphor, just an idea that people in the ancient world held on to kind of control people. But modern science has taught us so much more about the way the world works, and there is no God. In fact, it would be best if there was no religion too. That's the idea of the modern world, that you and I are basically accidents, or maybe we'd say random. That we can look in the mirror, this modern view says, and say one word that would be so devastating if you believed it about yourself. The modern way of thinking is that you can look in the mirror and say whatever. Whatever. You're nobody. By the time you're gone, the world will go on, you will be forgotten. All the things that you did and all the things that you stood for and all the aspects of the person that you were mean nothing, because they were entirely accidental. And if that is the perspective, if that's the worldview, how tragic it is for you, for us, anyone that would believe that. Because we have no purpose. There's no value to us. A friend of ours, my wife and I live in Texas, and there was a friend next door. Her husband died a couple years ago, and she finally cleaned out the garage and brought me a box of old tools. And she said to me, these are her husband's name was Larry. These are Larry's old tools. Do you want them? And I looked at the box and I said, yeah, I'll take them. I didn't want to say no. You say yes. I took them. And I saw some things in there that I knew what they were, you know, old pliers and a screwdriver and a pry bar and a few things like that. But there was this round, heavy metal, like donut. And I took it, but I didn't know what it was. I didn't know its utility, didn't know its purpose. It was about to be thrown out. I pulled it aside and I said, what is this? And I began to just experiment. I, to this day, cannot tell you what that thing is for. And it will be thrown out the next time I clean out my garage. It is a whatever. And see, that's the tragedy of the modern world. As they look at life, your life, my life, the life of people that we love and lost, the life of things that have we've thought they've made a difference, and they discount it, they deconstruct it to the point where it says, well, whatever. It's stray. You are a stray, an accident. And into that kind of thinking comes an amazing idea that there is a God. And there is a God, and behind that image, that you, whatever you have of God, is a person and a personality and a realness, a reality. And that reality is love. And suddenly, we don't look at our lives anymore and we say, well, whatever. You know what we say instead? We are forever. We're not whatever, we are forever. We will be able, in God, through Christ, to live a life forever. And that changes the equation for everything. That the God who's made heaven and earth is actually for you. He's not detached, he is attached to you. He cares about you, he has an interest in your life. And all we need to do is look at the life of Ray David and Monica, and we can see that the God that they believe in, our God, was never detached from their life. As tragic as some of the circumstances were, they knew God was there all along the way. And now God has brought this together in an incredible way. And when they look at each other, when they get excited, when they think about the life ahead, you know what they're thinking? What they ought to be thinking? What I'm asking you to envision you thinking? Is that all of this is not about, well, whatever. It's about doing things that last forever. I want you to know something. In just a few minutes, they are going to exchange vows. It's got forever written all over it. It's got love and permanence and commitment and loyalty written all over it. And some of you know exactly what I'm talking about because you made a vow to your wife, to your husband, however many years ago, and you have trusted that God has sustained you and led you through this life's journey. But some of you may not know what I'm talking about. You may actually, if you think about it, look in the mirror yourselves and imagine that you are regarded as some kind of random tool that is going to live a life of whatever and not be aware of what comes forever. And the truth of the matter is that what happened in Jesus Christ 2,000 years ago is that he came. His foreverness, his life, his blood came into our life. And everyone who believes in him has a life forever. What an extraordinary opportunity. What an extraordinary thing to think that it would take God to reveal himself into a life, and then it would take me to understand who that is and embrace it and then live forever. That's really what's being said when it says God is love. It means God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son to the end that anyone who would believe in him would never be a whatever, but would live forever. Monica and RD, the way this works out in your marriage will be that you'll look at each other in good times and bad, and you'll never want to say to one another, well, whatever. Whatever you are, whatever was the reason we got married, you never want to say words like that. Instead, you say, we are forever because of God. And what do you find when you find a foreverness? You look at the life of Jesus. You know what you find? You find all the things in Jesus that are required in a marriage. You find forgiveness. You find compassion. You find hope. You find a protection of children. You find a man that honors women. You find women that help and encourage and love men. You find courage to do the right thing when the wrong thing is all around you. You effectively find the Lord and Savior of your life in Jesus Christ, and he can build his life in you forever. And I would just want to say two other things. Actually, one other thing to Matthew and Kennedy. You both have a chance in the next decade to see something amazing happen before your very eyes. I know you may go through times where you say, I believe in God. You may go through times where you say, I don't believe in God. But I want you to just remember this moment right now. You are going to see God work a miracle in the lives of your parents. You're going to see basically what was an accidental, random, whatever meeting turn into a partnership that will last forever. And you're going to see it in all of its glory and sometimes hardship as God moves this couple toward each other. They are aware that the vows that they make are permanent, that the consequences of what they are doing, pulling your family together, are enormous. And I just want to encourage you, Matthew and Kennedy, to consider deeply what your life would look like if you opened your heart and your mind to the forever possible love of Jesus Christ, and that you embraced it, that you too not only could witness what God could do in the life of your parents, what he can do in your life as well. If God is love, well, he loves you too. Well, I don't know if I'll be preaching here tomorrow or not, but I'm done for today. And I just want to say to you that the joy that I sense in this couple is infectious. And if that joy causes you to wonder, what is it that they have that I might have for myself? I want to tell you the answer. They have a heart that understands God is love forever. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. If you would join right hands, please. Take a small step forward, if you would. RD is giving me instructions. This is not my first rodeo, RD.
I'm used to being here.
So, Ray David, will you give yourself to Monica to be your husband, to love her, comfort her, honor and protect her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Monica, will you give yourself to Ray David to be his wife, to love him, comfort him, honor and protect him, and forsaking all others, to be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? And then this is intended for the families of Ray David and Monica. Do you, members of the families of Ray David and Monica, give your blessing to this marriage? If so, please say, we do. And then this is to the congregation. Everyone here that knows and loves this couple, you are the witnesses to these vows now being made. Will you do all in your power to support and uphold this marriage? If so, you say, we will.
We will.
Now we will hear the vows. Guess you do.
Yeah. I'm really nervous. I'll get nervous. So I wrote them down, Monty. Sorry, just give me a second. Monica, I've loved you from the first time that we met. I'll always remember driving you back to your car at the end of our first date. And you were shocked when I said to you on the first date, I said, I'm not looking to fill a Friday night, I'm looking for a wife. And I said, I can't promise you how our time together will work out, but it can only end one of two ways. Either we'll figure out that we're not right for each other and go our separate ways, or we'll end up together forever. And on that first date, I said to you, but I promise either way you'll look back and say that you've never been loved any better. Well, here we are making our vows to spend the rest of our lives together, to build a family together, to face life together, and to serve the Lord together. And Monty, I don't know what the future holds. I'm sure we'll have loads of fun together. I'm also certain that there will be times of difficulty. But the promise that I made to you on the night of our first date 4 years ago still stands. I will love you better than you've ever been loved. So I, Ray David, take you, Monica, to be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
For the rest of our lives.
For the rest of our lives.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow. Yours are longer.
They're not. They're just written. Ray David, I love you. I love you in immeasurable ways that I didn't even know were possible. I know that our love is heaven sent because you are an answer to prayer and an example of God's goodness. I am so excited about our little family and about the life we are about to build together.
Does anyone have a tissue?
I will love you unconditionally in the perfect times and in those moments of difficulty. I will support you, respect you, encourage you, be your best friend and your biggest cheerleader. I will try not to be stubborn and to apologize quickly when I am wrong, although that seldomly happens. You are more than I could ever have hoped for, and everything I need. I, Monica, take you, Ray David, to be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
For this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better and for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer and for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
For the rest of our lives.
For the rest of our lives.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
And the rings. Dear friends in Christ, let us ask God to bless these rings that they may be symbols of the vows and the covenant that Ray David and Monica have made this day. Blessed are you, God of steadfast love, source of our joy and the end of our hope. Bless these rings given and received that they may be a symbol of the vow and covenant that Ray David and Monica have made this day through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. You repeat after me. Monica, I give you this ring.
Monica, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
With all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you in the name of God.
I honor you in the name of God.
Monica, if you take his ring and you repeat after me. Ray David, I give you this ring.
Ray David, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
And with all that I am.
All that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you in the name of God.
I honor you in the name of God.
And now that Monica and Ray David have joined themselves to each other by solemn vows, signified by the joining of hands and the giving and receiving of rings, I declare that they are husband and wife in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. And those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Everybody, please say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Well, we have a featured kiss later, but it seems like there ought to be one now, all right? You can tell certainly that this place is just filled with love, and a lot of the preparation has been prayer, getting, as Monica said, an answer to prayer. And now's the time to pray. And I'm going to ask Angela to come forward and bring Register, sorry, RD's controlling again. So let's do the register, and we will get that done. Thank you, RD.
And keep my eyes.
Angela, if you'd come forward.
Here you go. All children are welcome.
Come on up, please.
You're just visiting. Come on up.
Come on up and... Hi. Maggie, I need you over here. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. I'm here. Well, now, oh. Thank you. Well, now that you are married, the children have been talking about marriage and promises that you have just made to each other, and they have got some words of wisdom and some prayers as you step out into your married life. So Maggie's going to start us off.
Monica and Ray David, the children have some special prayers and thoughts to share on your wedding day.
So we got some children here. Where's my Sarah? Hello, Sarah. What have you got to say?
I pray that you tell each other to love them every day.
Thank you. Where's my Grace? Hello, Grace.
Monica, we pray that you will always save some dinner if Ray David's home late.
That's a good prayer. Say that one too.
Where's Jack?
What have you got?
Well, when every morning when my dad and me go out and put mommy's purse and everything in her car and start it up in the winter so she isn't cold when she goes to work.
Have you got it?
That's a good idea.
Okay. Where's my Sydney?
Ray David and Monica, don't forget to always have a date night and have fun together. I think it will always be nice if Ray David washes Monica's car once a week.
Got it.
Otis, what have you got to say?
I hope Ray David takes Monica to the park to play on the swings and the slides.
That's good, Otis. That's a good one. Thank you.
Theo?
Ray David, we pray you will always protect Monica every day and keep her safe.
Yes. Emmett? Where's that, my Emmett?
I saw
him. He's here. Hello, sweetie. Here you go. Where's Ray David got to take Monica?
To Krabby Joe's.
You have to take Monica to Krabby Joe's.
Oh, okay. I can do that.
And what's he got to buy her?
Kinder Egg.
And please buy her a Kinder Egg to have some fun.
Oh, that's a good idea. I will do that.
Where's my Ezra?
Ezra's right here.
Hello, Ezra.
I pray that way David plants some way flowers for Monica.
Okay, plant some flowers.
Zoe?
I pray that you always keep each other safe and that you teach Matthew and Kennedy to take care of each other.
That's good. Zoe, I'm going to do that.
Elizabeth, do you have a song to sing? Are you going to stand up just up
a
there a minute?
Song to sing?
She does.
Do you want me to hold you while you sing?
Okay, you're going to sing. Ready, go.
Says me, yes, I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong, they are weak, but he is wrong.
Well done, thank you. Does anybody else have anything they'd like to say? Maggie's going to wrap it up in prayer.
I think Brennan wanted to, and so does Benny. Come on up, Benny. Don't be shy. Come on up.
Benny, what did you want to say?
Thank you for God.
Thank you for God. I love that one. That is wonderful. Thank you, Benny. And who was the other one?
Brennan, did you want it?
I love my bubbles a lot.
There you go. Thank you. Did you want to say something?
I heard you.
You did. Okay. Maggie's going to wrap it up. Thank you, Maggie.
Let us pray. Jesus, please bless Monica and Ray David as they promise to love and take care of each other every day. We pray that you will read your Bibles and share your prayers together and that Jesus will always be the center of your lives. In the name of Jesus, amen.
Amen.
Thank you, guys.
So as these children go back to their seats, we want to ask three men to come forward and pray. And it would probably be best, Ray David, if you explained who these men were to the family.
Yeah, Jason, do you want to come up first? Come on up. Jason Small, apart from being kind of family, married to Mary, it's so we're kind of related, but even more importantly today, this has been Monica's pastor for many, many years. And I thank you, Jason, for your influence in Monica's life. So we wanted you to pray for us.
Thanks so much. Monica, it's been such a journey watching you grow in your faith. I'm just so proud of you and believing the great things God has. I remember the day Ray David called me to ask me about you. And before... And as Monica's pastor, I'm somewhat protective over her. But he asked all the right questions, and I was so proud. So let us pray. Mighty God, we just say thank you. God, for your story, for your plan for our lives. God, that sometimes we don't understand at the moment, but then we see it as it unfolds, and Lord, just such an amazing story. And today we speak blessing on this couple. Today we say thank you that you have brought them together. We say thank you for their love for you, Lord, and their commitment to one another and to the family, Lord. Lord, we pray blessing, Lord, on Kennedy. We pray blessing on Matthew. We pray blessing on Ray David. Lord, we pray your blessing on Monica. Lord, we know that great things are to come for them. And so, Lord, I pray that they would stay so close to your heart and so close to one another therein. And so, God, we speak, God, your story even in a greater way unfolding in them. That your love, Lord, with purpose, as was shared earlier, God, would be lived out through their lives. Lord, for the many miracles that you've done to bring them to this moment, we say thank you. And we celebrate this relationship. We celebrate this commitment in your name. Amen.
Amen.
Charlie is my good friend and my bishop, and we've asked you to pray for us as well, too, please, Charlie.
Thank you, Ray David and Monica. I'm honored to do so. I've been a colleague in ministry with Ray David now for many years, and like David, went through the rough things as well as now delighted to see what God has done in you both, and it's my joy to pray now. Lord Jesus, we love you. We love you so much because you first loved us. And we thank you for what you did on the cross to win salvation for us. And we thank you for your resurrection where you conquered death. We thank you for your ascension and for your coming return that we look forward to with much joy. We thank you for pouring out your Holy Spirit who lives in our hearts and lives in Ray David's, lives in Monica's hearts, delivered all that Jesus, you came to do. And we thank you for this visible sign of your goodness and love today in this service. We thank you for what you've done, and we know that you've only just begun. And so we pray. I think of the words of David that said, "Delight yourself in the Lord, and he will give you the desires of your heart." And so I pray, Lord, that you would be right at the center, as the children prayed, right at the center of their life. They would find their delight in you, Lord. And as they do, they would find great delight in each other's company more and more. And that you would cause them to be fruitful in life and in ministry, and through it all, know much joy in your presence together. Bless Matthew, bless Kennedy, Bless this family, and we pray all this in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Charlie.
Bless you, brother. Bless you.
Thank you. And the last man that we've asked to pray for us needs no introduction to some of you. It's my dad, Ray H. Glenn, better known as Poppy. Poppy, we love you.
The feeling is mutual, I assure you. Let's pray. Father in heaven, we worship you today.
Thank you, Lord.
We praise you, Lord, for you alone are worthy.
Thank you, Lord.
Lord, thank you for the opportunity to gather here with family and friends and witness the exchange of the marriage vows between Ray David and Monica. Father, we just pray that as they put their new home together in the very near future, that it would be a place where your presence will reign supreme.
Yes, Lord.
Your presence will be felt, and it will minister to everyone who ever walks through the door. We pray, Lord, for Matthew and Kennedy.
Yes.
Lord, during this transition period, we know we can trust you to take care of them.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, we just pray that whatever their needs may be, spiritual or emotional, Lord, we know that you will meet them.
Yes.
And we also know that they know to go to you if they have any needs. Lord, we just thank you for your many, many blessings. Lord, we pray that as Ray David continues in ministry, that there will be a powerful anointing, a double portion, Lord, we claim in Jesus' name. And Lord, we just pray for this beautiful congregation who have been so supportive and so kind to Ray Dave and Monica. We pray a special blessing on every home that's represented, every family, Lord, every person that's part of this church. And we pray, Lord, that there will be a tremendous growth and that this lighthouse will reach many, many people in the area and beyond.
Yes.
So, God, we just thank you. We know that you're able to perform on every promise you ever made.
Thank you.
We thank you in advance. We pray a special blessing on our friends and family that are here today, and a special blessing on Ray Dave and Monica.
Yes.
As they set out together. Lord, make it an exciting and a happy and a productive journey. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen.
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 Amen. Thank you, Poppy.
Okay, if you would step forward, and Matthew, come real close. Kennedy, come real close. Close, 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 close. This way, this way, this way, this way, this way. Yeah. Would you please stand? Father God, you sanctified a home for our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ in Nazareth. You love families. You place those who are alone in families, and you have given the joy of this new couple the privilege of being able to raise and to nurture and honor the gifts and the abilities of Kennedy and Matthew. And we pray, Lord, that for these two young people, you would be all that they need, that you would supply their every wish, their every hope, their every desire. And Lord, that you would bind this family together as a as a new family in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. And so I pray, God the Father, and God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, to bless, preserve, and keep you. The Lord mercifully with his favor look upon you for and fill you with all spiritual benediction and grace. And especially upon these two, Monica and Ray David, that you may faithfully live together in this life and in the age to come have life everlasting. Amen. And if you would please get ready for a moment, there's another kiss coming. You may kiss your bride. Again, let's applause is appropriate. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. When I touch them there.